Hey guys, ELP Modeling here, and today we are looking at the recently re-released Fujimi Mitsubishi Evolution 9. Now, I'll start off by showing you your decals. Also, thankfully, Fujimi have re-released quite a few kits that were actually quite hard to get hold of, and now they've added window masks. So, you know, a bit speechless about that, but fair play. Can't complain of that. Now, your decals. You get BBS ones, JDM plates to do whatever you want with, MR ones. Now, these are going to be the standard sort of decals that you get with everyone. I'm hoping they bring the MR one out. That'd be quite cool. I know they're re-releasing the Evo 7, so hopefully the 8 will come as well. Now, dials, gold Mitsubishi ones as well, which is a bit strange. You also get some quite cool, like, carbon Kevlar decals as well for the spoiler. That's quite nice. And various other little bits and pieces as well, like the Recaro ones as well. Now, on with the actual kit. Now, this is your typical Fujimi Evo kit. They're all the same apart from the bodies. However, this is slightly different. Link to the instructions guides in the description. Now, clear pieces, these are very different. For a start, this is separate. They're usually molded all on the same sprue, all one piece. And then your front and rear lights, I'll flip these over for you. There are your front ones. And then of course your rear. And then you've got the various other bits for the headlights and then the side repeaters as well. That's a nice touch, those side repeaters. There's actually an indent in the body. But we'll get to that in a little bit. Now, I was hoping they'd have fixed something, but they haven't. There's a humongous bit of flash there, look. But you've got the wing mirrors there, the front grille. These are MR mirrors. Yeah, the rally art ones. That, I'm not entirely sure what that is. It's probably for the bumper area. A couple of other little bits and pieces. You've got an aerial handbrake. Now, I was hoping they'd have fixed these brakes at the front, but they haven't. I'll flip this over for you to see. The thing that bugs me with these kits is that you've got a full disc at the back, but at the front it's sort of missing half the disc, look, where the steering arm is. And I just, it's just, why they've done it like that. They could have just made it a full disc. It's not, oh well, just one of those things. But front bumper, which is separate, which is a first, the 7s and 8s are all moulded as one, whereas this 9 is completely different. No idea why they've done that, but probably cheaper, I guess, but who knows. There's your rear bumper with a really cool diffuser. These are fantastic looking cars in real life. And there's the front of your wing mirrors as well. Just the usual wing mirrors, nothing spectacular. Now, the chassis is exactly the same. And if you've seen the other Evo videos, it's not the worst chassis, but it's not the best either. Some of it's moulded in and some of it isn't. But there you have it. Rear wheels attach via a rod, which makes lowering easier. But yeah, not an awful lot to say about the chassis. It's, not great, but it's not that bad either. Front wipers, and then that piece isn't used, I believe. There is quite a few pieces that aren't used, but you've also got extra wing mirrors as well. Front lower arms, which are all moulded in one piece, and there's a bit of the cat as well, I believe, of the exhaust, which is a disappointment again. Rear subframe area, and then this black exhaust isn't used. That's for the Evo 3, and there is an unboxing of that on the channel as well, if you want to go and take a look. You've got a steering arm, and then your intercooler. It's very strange doing this because it's so different yet so similar to the other kits. Now, the interior is exactly the same, that's completely unchanged. You've got the center console molded in there. You can see a bit of the detail there. It's quite hard to show you detail on white things, but there you have it. It would have been nice if the door cards were separate, or it would have been nice if Hiroshima made the kit. Whoops. But there's your gear shifter and gator. Yeah, and this is what is strange to see, the backings of the headlights and rear lights. But I'm not complaining at all. A couple of other little bits here, I've no idea what that is. This little thing here. I'll have to double check, but you've got your steering column and your rear view mirror. Now, the seats look fantastic from the front. You can see all the detail there. However, when you look at the back, that's the only problem with them. So you're going to have to fill that top piece in with styrene if you're going to drill the holes out so you're not left with a cavity, and then put a bit of styrene on the top of that to then cover this lower section. But it's not an awful lot of work, but it's just a bit of a pain, that's all. Now, two sprues left. Here's the exhaust that you actually use. You need to snip a bit of the other exhaust off that I showed you, sorry. You do use the most of it, but you have to snip it off, and then that lays over the top of it. More wipers. That's for an Evo 7, I believe. And then you've got some dash pieces, you know, like the heating controls and whatnot. Rear spoiler, and then your dashboard. Voila. Then you've got a steering wheel, another gear shifting bit, rear wiper, antenna, and then part of your spoiler, a humongous exhaust, which looks really cool. That's a nice touch. And then you've got some more mirrors. There's like three separate mirrors you can use on this. Now, here we go. This is saying on the sprue Evo 8, so I presume it's going to use the same spoiler. And there you have it. That's for the lower section of the dash. There's even more dash bits, look. You go completely blank, look, and have like no radio, but just the heating control, which is quite cool, or like a climate control unit. And then you've got the pegs that attach the wheels. Of course, the front, the rears are a rod. Now, before I get to the body, Fujimi have addressed one of the issues that was in the older kits. Now, the Evo 3 comes with this as well. In scale mesh. Now, the stuff that came with the older ones was ridiculous. I was going to show you the bumper, but it's not attached. But you can see that it's really fine. It is silver. Whether you wanted to keep it silver or not, it's up to you. But, and it's metal as well, which is nice. So you could easily paint that. Thank God they've done that, because the mesh that came before was so out of scale. It was more 1/12 mesh. But now, your wheels are here. I will show you these up against the body in a little bit. The wheel to tire ratio is pretty much spot on. Whether you're going to use them or not is another thing. They do look fantastic on Enki NT03s, by the way. And there you have that. I lied, there is another sprue, sorry about that. And this is Evo 9 specific, so here is the exhaust tip you'll use, which is moulded in chrome. And you've also got the side mirror inserts as well. Set of polycaps and your rod, and last but not least is your body. Now, it looks as though they've improved completely on the mold lines for a start. I can't really feel any huge ones. There is a little one on the back there, and that is about it, really. I mean, over the course of prepping the whole body and sanding it and whatnot, what little mold lines are there you're going to go through anyway, so it doesn't matter. But it is fantastic, it really is. Nice details on there. That is how the front bumper attaches. Now, I did notice on here, there is a very small bit for you to glue for the side bumper. So what I'd recommend is putting the bumper on, sort of taping it up, and then gluing a piece of styrene to the back of the bumper so these line up. Then glue it on, and then on the back piece, use another piece of styrene. You'll get a much better hold than it. I did it on the Subaru Sandbar and it worked a treat, it really did. Now, the rest of the body. Here is the rear. Same story again with a rear bumper, very small piece there. So just use the same method with that. Now, the only issue I've got is that it's probably me being lazy, but there's nothing for the spoiler to attach to. You've just got a complete flat bit there, which is a bit of a pain. But it's not the end of the world. But yeah, I cannot fault how this body is moulded. There is your separate piece for the side repeaters as well. And as promised, I'll quickly show these wheels up against it as well. Now this is of course the slammed look, but it's easier for me to hold it like that. But there you have it. They don't look too bad actually. Probably because they're silver. If they were a dark colour, they'd probably look very small, but it's pretty cool. They'd probably look good on something else actually. They're not bad looking wheels at all. But that wraps up this video then, guys. Let me know what you think. I'm really impressed with Fujimi. They've gone to the effort of giving us window masks, which, as I'm sure you know, is the worst thing that I can do with modelling. I hate doing the windows, but it does make life easier when you've got window masks. But yeah, I can't really fault the kit. I wasn't expecting Fujimi to do a brand new tooling of the Evo kits. It wouldn't make financial sense, I guess, for them to do it. But, you know, you've got the base there to make a very good model. And with the inclusion of the Evo engines that are coming out now by 81 and a hobby design, you can just go crazy with it. Stick an engine in it. Why not? So that is it, guys. Let me know what you think. Leave a comment. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Share away. And I will see you guys in the next videos and on Instagram at ELP_modeling. And take it easy, guys. Bye-bye.